The Knights Templar was an organization of devout Christian warriors that quickly rose to power in the medieval era. Templar Knights had iron rules in their order that affected their normal day-to-day life off the battlefield. In this video, we'll be going over some of the insanely strict and ridiculous rules that Templar Knights had to follow. Templar brothers started their days at 4 a.m. for morning prayer. Prayer was very important in a Templar's life, and they had prayers many times a day. Templars were also required to stay until the chapel services were done. Getting dressed also had many rules, including wearing white habits to symbolize purity and chastity and abandoning the life of darkness. Many things were not permitted for clothing, such as finery or fancy clothes, and no pointed shoes or shoelaces, because these abominable things belonged to pagans. Then it was on to mealtime. Brothers ate in pairs to save on dishes and so that brothers could study the other more closely to ensure that no rules were being broken. Meals were eaten in silence and they were not allowed to leave the table unless it was a serious emergency. Meat was only eaten 3 times a week except on special holidays because eating flesh corrupts the body. When eating, a brother could share some of his food with the other brothers around him, but could only give out food as far as he could stretch out his arm. And rules were put in place to keep the Templars far away from the temptations of women. Women were not allowed into the Templar home because the company of a woman is a dangerous thing, for by it the old devil has led many from the straight path to paradise. Many things were strictly forbidden regarding women, including looking at a woman too much, kissing a woman, even kissing mothers or sisters, talking about women too much, and lying with a woman was definitely forbidden. If something sexual did happen with a woman, he had better hope that no one found out, because if they did, he would be kicked out of the order. This was all pretty hypocritical, because although rare, there was actually a few female Templars. Templars were trained to be strictly obedient to their superiors, who were called masters, and needed permission for most of the things that had to be done throughout the day. Brothers needed permission to bathe, bleed themselves, take medicine, go into town, ride a horse, shorten stirrup leathers or saddle girths, adjust their sword belt, hang up their chainmail, throw a lance, repair a sword or coat of mail, carry or keep money, carry baggage on their horses, plus more. So they basically needed permission to do anything. Breaking any of the minor rules could mean that brothers had to eat on the floor or receive a beating. If it was more than a minor infraction, they would get kicked out of the order. In between prayers and mealtimes, Templars were expected to work. Idleness was not permitted. Templars were expected to bring honor to the order by being holy and above reproach, and not have traits like jealousy or envy or anything else that could cause issues inside of the order. Things that were not allowed were drinking, gambling, and swearing, which are probably pretty obvious, but chess and backgammon were also not allowed. Brothers were discouraged from owning anything. Everything was regarded as property of the order as opposed to the individual knights. Brothers were not even allowed to receive personal letters from family members or anyone else. However, if the master allowed it, the letters could be read to the brother. And if a brother left the house and slept 2 nights out of the house, he would lose his habit for 1 year and 1 day. When brothers got done with the night prayers, they were not allowed to speak and had to go to their beds in silence. And when they slept, there always had to be a light so that shadowy enemies may not lead them to wickedness. The Templar Knights had a very strict code and religious devotion and viewed breaking the rules as a fate worse than death. The Templar's code was designed to keep the warrior knights humble and obedient. The strict rules off the battlefield caused the Templar knights to be fierce, obedient warriors on the battlefield. On the battlefield, Templars were not allowed to retreat, surrender, or charge without permission, which are excellent qualities for any army that needs to remain disciplined. The Templar knights had a very quick rise to wealth and power and ruled for about 2 centuries before the order got disbanded. Remember to hit that like button and make sure you subscribe if you haven't already to see more content. Let me know in the comments section which rule you thought was the craziest.